Ravi has three children, two daughters and one son. All were born on the same date in different years. The sum of the ages of the two daughters today is smaller than the age of the son today. But a year from now, the sum of the ages of the daughters will equal the age of the son. 3 years from today, the difference between the age of the son and the combined ages of the daughters will be. 3 years from today, the difference between the age of the son and the combined ages of the daughters will be. Options given are 1, 2, 3, minus 2 or minus 1. So let's take this up, right? See what it says. So if you just try to highlight the important points, this guy Ravi has got three children, two daughters and one son, right? So since it is on ages, let's assume the ages of daughters are D1, D2 and the age of the son is S, right? These are their current ages, present ages, D1, D2 and S. All were born on the same date in different years. All were born on the same date in different years, meaning the difference in their ages or anything to do with their ages will be an integral multiple of number of years. You understand? It will be an integer, right? It will be like 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. It cannot be 1.5 years, 2 years, 2.5 years or so on. It cannot be a non-integer value, the difference or the sum of their ages, right? It has to be an integer value. Now, the sum of the ages of the two daughters today is smaller than the age of the son today. So sum of the ages of the two daughters today is smaller than the age of the son today. So what is the sum of the ages of the two daughters today? D1 plus D2. It is smaller than the age of the son today. So basically this is one equation given to us or inequation given to us. D1 plus D2 is less than S. But a year from now, the sum of the ages of the daughters will equal the age of the son. Now that's an important statement. But a year from now, what do you mean by a year from now? 1 year later. After 1 year. After 1 year, the sum of the ages of the daughters will equal the age of the son. Now understand, their present ages are D1, D2 and S. What will be their ages after 1 year? D1's age will be D1 plus 1. D2's age will be D2 plus 1. And S age, the son's age will be S plus 1. Right? All their ages will increase by 1 year. So, but a year from now, after one year, the sum of the ages of the daughters, sum of the ages of the daughters, which means D1 plus 1 plus D2 plus 1 will equal the age of the son, will equal the age of the son. So try to get that equation now. Sum of the ages after 1 year, D1 plus 1 plus D2 plus 1 will equal the age of the son, S plus 1. Sum of the ages of the daughters will equal the age of the son. So from this, what do you get? You get D1 plus D2 plus 2 equals to S plus 1. Or if you simplify it further, we get S minus D1 plus D2 equals to 1. Very important conclusion, right? So the age of the son minus the sum of the ages of the daughters is equal to 2 minus 1, 1 year, right? It will be equal to 1. Yeah. So it says that in the current scenario, in the current state of things, see, all D1, D2 and S are present ages. So if you look at the present ages, the difference between the sum of the ages of daughters and the son's age is 1 year, right? Now see what it says. 3 years from today, 3 years from today, the difference between the age of the son and the combined age of the daughters will be. 3 years from today, the difference between the age of the son and the combined age of daughters will be. Now when you read this statement, by the time you finish reading this last statement, that after 3 years, what will be the difference between the age of the son and the combined age of the daughters? You should, I mean, if you work smartly, you would know that the answer is going to be 1. Answer should be 1. Without putting pen on paper. See, understand that we have already got the difference. This equation here is about the difference of their ages. First of all, I do not understand why in the options have they used plus and minus. Because the question here is on difference, right? Difference doesn't really worry about sign. It is only about magnitude. See, for example, when I say A is equal to 4 and B is equal to 9, what is the difference between A and B? We don't say that the difference between A and B is minus 5. The difference between A and B is 5. See, difference is always about the magnitude. It doesn't consider the direction, right? A minus B is minus 5. A minus B, 4 minus 9 will be minus 5. B minus A is plus 5. But A difference B or B difference A is always 5. So when you're talking about difference or when he is actually referring to difference, he should not be giving negative values at all. But then since negative values have also been given, you have to be careful. Yeah. However, what I'm trying to tell you is that point about 3 years from now doesn't matter. It is redundant. It is irrelevant. Right? If the difference between their ages today is 1 year, see here we have already got the difference. If the difference between their ages, son's age and the sum of the ages of the daughters is 1 year today, Even after 3 years, the difference will remain the same. Even after 10 years, the difference will remain the same. 4 years ago also, the difference was the same. 29 years ago also, the difference was the same. No? Yes? Or will it change? Or will it change? We have to be careful, right? Will it change or not change? See, if it is about... Now I think you have to understand one point here. If it is about only two persons, A and B, like look at the example that are given, right? If it is about only two persons, like difference between the ages of A and B today is 5 years. Even after 10 years, the difference will remain 5 years. Yeah? Even after 10 years, the difference will remain 5 years. Even after 10 years, the difference will remain 5 years. Or any number of years, the difference will remain 5 years. Because both of them are increasing by the same value, right? Like if you say currently the age of A is 4 years and B's age is 9 years, after 2 years, so the present difference is 5 years. The present difference of their age is 5 years. What happens after 2 years? A's age will increase by 2 years. B's age also will increase by 2 years. So when both the values have increased by 2 years, the difference will remain the same. After 7 years, A's age increases by 7 years. B's age increases by 7 years. When both of them have increased by same value, the difference will remain the same. So when there are only two persons, A and B, or when there are only two variables, the difference will remain the same. But then, important point to be noted is, while it is talking about difference, the number of persons involved here are three. The number of persons involved here are three. And it's one individual person against a group of persons, against two persons together. So the difference may not remain the same. You're able to follow? See, I'm not trying to confuse you, but you should understand both the cases. If there were only two variables, straight variables, S and D, we would have straight marked the answer as 1 or minus 1. I mean, anyway, since he has used negative signs also, we have to be careful about plus 1 or minus 1. But then I'm saying the magnitude would have been 1. If there are only two persons, but here there are three persons involved, right? Three persons involved. So you have to be a little careful. Yeah. So what do you do? He's asking us to find out the difference of their ages 3 years from today, 3 years from today, 3 years from today. So what can be done? Will the answer remain one or will it change? Will the answer still remain one or will it change? It'll change because like I've mentioned already, one person against two persons. How will you find out the change there? How will you find out the change? Just consider ages after 3 years. See, present ages are these, right? What will be the ages after 3 years? D1 plus 3, D2 plus 3, and S plus 3. Yeah? Now, we know one equation already. Try to get the required equation. The difference between the age of the son and the combined age of the daughters, right? So, what will be the age of the son? S plus 3 minus combined ages of daughters. So, D1 plus 3 plus D2 plus 3 equals to what? So simplify, what do we get? S minus of D1 plus D2. S minus of D1 plus D2. Now look at this. This plus 3 and 1 minus 3 gets cancelled. Finally, we are left with minus 3 equals to what? You're able to follow? This is what is asked in the question. The difference between the age of the son and the combined age of the daughters. So age of the son after 3 years is S plus 3. Combined ages of the daughters after 3 years will be D1 plus 3 plus D2 plus 3. Right? So from this, I am trying to get one portion out, which is S minus of D1 plus D2. S minus of D1 plus D2. And then in terms of the other constants, we have plus 3, minus 3, minus 3. So plus 3 and minus 3 gets cancelled. We are left with 1 minus 3. Now you have already found that S minus of D1 plus D2 is plus 1. Substitute that here. S minus of D1 plus D2 is equal to 1. So what will the final answer be? We can say question mark will be equal to 1 minus 3. What is 1 minus 3? Minus 2. So that's your final answer. Minus 2, which is option 4. Are you able to follow? Minus 2, option 4 is the final answer. Again, I repeat that last point. See, it's easy to solve, nothing complex about it, but it can arise, you know, it can lead to a confusion. We have solved such questions in the past where I've always mentioned that the difference between the ages of two persons will remain constant. Today, if the difference between the ages of A and B is 5 years, the difference between the ages of A and B always will remain 5 years. Whether you go in the past or in the future, because both of them will increase or decrease parallelly. Yes or no? Today, the difference is 5 years. After 7 years, A's age grows by 7 years, B's age also grows by 7 years. After 23 years, A's grows by 23 years, and so is the age of B. So when both of them have increased or decreased by the same value, the difference will remain the same. But that is only when two persons are involved. Here also, we are talking about difference, but then this is not about two persons. It is about one person against a group of two persons. Or three persons. So in that case, the difference will not remain the same. Because on one side, only one value increases by 3, other value has increased by 6. So that's why it leads to a different value. So you have to be a little careful here. Yeah. So when you simplify finally, you get the answer as option 4, which is -2.